Once if everything is ready.
Yes, let's start off the meeting.
Okay. Okay, just a minute. Okay, so good evening to all the attendees, distant officers, fellow Toastmasters, and speakers for the day. Welcome to the second session of the Branding Dilemma. In today's session, we'll be talking about some practical and effective ways to put forward information which is relevant to Toastmasters, but in the most creative way. For this, we have divided this session into two segments. First, we'll not only be discussing about the PR strategies, but also the tools and the best way of using them to give your thoughts a picture, or maybe even a video, which will help you convey the information in the best way possible. But before we proceed with the first segment, I would like to lay down some rules. I request all the attendees to turn off their audio throughout the session. However, they can choose to turn on their videos throughout. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the chat box. We'll also be having a Q&A session at the end of every segment to clarify doubts. Now, let us now move on to the first segment of today's session. That is, we'll be talking about Canva. Now, Canva is a tool which is very famous for being used among many Toastmasters, and this is one of my favorite tools as well. And trust me, when it comes to the branding guidelines of a Toastmaster, there can't be a better option. Today, we have a very credible facilitator who's going to speak about Canva. She has been a Toastmaster for a little over 2 years now. She has served as a VPPR in her previous term. She's also a former division PR member and has worked for several PR initiatives such as Jampact. Let us now welcome Toastmaster Sparsha. Over to you, Toastmaster Sparsha.
Am I audible and visible then?
Yes, you're audible.
Is there any lag on my end?
No.
All
right. You're good to go.
Thank you so much, Rupali. Thanks for the hefty introduction as well. And I would also like to extend my thanks for the entire division PR team for giving me this opportunity. I'm particularly grateful because the entire last year I've been spending a lot of time just designing on Canva, and I thought I deserve a break this year. But every now and then I feel a little nostalgic whenever I look at a poster. So thanks a lot, team, for giving me this opportunity. So yeah, today we are here to learn about Canva, and I'm here to share my knowledge about Canva and the little practices that I've been following when I'm designing something on this tool. So, and I think this particular discussion is very fruitful for most of the members, because I know many people who are close to me are just getting started in designing, and all this concern to make brand compliant designs. And I think that's really going to be helpful for most of the people. And I myself have encountered many VPPRs who have not designed a single poster or design, but now that they are a VPPR, they have to learn it. So here the session is completely for them. So by designing, I just don't mean any kind of posters. There are many other scenarios that we are going to cover. So today in this session, we are going to deliberate everything exclusively and strictly in the interest of Toastmasters. What are the different scenarios in Toastmasters when we get to design something, and what are the options available in Canva? And then we are going to have a quick demo on making a poster from the scratch. And last but not least, I'm going to share some tricks and shines that I follow to hack a creative poster. Right. So with this, before getting started, I want to first ask you all one question. Just take 5 seconds of time to tell me what you have understood by this slide. You can type in the chat box. Um, Friends, okay. Any other responses? Thank you. Okay. Any other responses? Guys, we can be a little interactive. I guess that's the one thing I'm expecting from you guys. Okay. So, okay. What did you understand by this? The second slide. Yes, exactly. So I think you already understand where I'm getting right now. The way you present whatever designs, the posters, it matters a lot. So the visual elements, the color, the font, the background, everything matters. So you can see in the previous slide, it's the same word, same letters, but and it might be a little much jazzy, but it's not one and the same. And that is how you are identifying Friends as a series from the second slide. So be it a brand, it could be a serial, a product, or an organization for a fact, the way you present, following the brand guidelines is that important. So a person looking at a meeting poster or a brochure of Toastmasters, they should not feel that, okay, it is some meeting poster, let me scroll down. It should not be like that. We want people to hold and think that, okay, that's a Toastmasters poster. It's going to be about public speaking, communication, leadership. That is why it is very important that we adhere to the brand guidelines. So on that note, let's have just quick 5 minutes of running through all the brand guidelines. First, let's go through the logos. First, we have different kind of logos. Sorry, 1 second. Yeah. So first we have these logos. Now these three logos are added this year, and we have these kind of logos with the pathways as well. And these logos related to paths, anytime you want to go for appreciation or path completion posters, you can go with these logos. And if there are any Gavaliers, that's a good news for you. This year the Toastmasters have launched this Gavel Club's logo, so you can use it from here on. Now this is all about the logos. The next thing is about the colors. We have primarily these three colors: true maroon, loyal blue, cool gray. Now I want you all to keep an eye on this hex code for each and every color, because we are going to use these hex codes whenever we want to customize anything on Canva. We are using these particular hex codes. So these are the primary colors that you can use for all the backgrounds. The next color is the accent color, which cannot be used as a background, but still you can use for design elements like dots, like lines, or any other design elements. You can use this happy yellow. Host, can you please help me mute the person? Yeah. And then we have the neutral colors, black and white. We can use only white as a background. However, we can use both black and white for any kind of text. This is all with regarding the colors. Then we move on to the fonts, which most of you are already aware. We have Gotham and Myriad Pro, and we have different flavors of it, but unfortunately these are not available on Canva. But if you have a pro account, you can anytime upload the files and you can use it. We'll discuss it in Q&A session, how to utilize these fonts in a pro account. However, we have these free alternatives in the brand manual that are available on Canva, that is Montserrat, Source Sans, and Arial. So make sure every time you're making any design that we are sticking to these three fonts particularly. Right now, the last thing we have are the images and the photography. We make sure that we are sticking to the concepts that are representing meetings, speeches, conferences, etc. But if you do not have any images related to this, you can always find the myriad of images in the Toastmasters library anytime. So that is all with all the brand guidelines, and I hope it's just a quick summary, guys, because I'm sticking to the purpose of the meeting, that is Canva completely. So you see, I'm speaking a lot about Canva, and even the MC told that it is one of her favorite tools. So as soon as someone is coming into Toastmasters and talking about designing, one word people come across is Canva. So why do you think there's a lot emphasis on Canva, according to you? You can again take time and chat, type in chat box. Okay, ease of use, Anything else? Needs a requirement? Okay. Free? Yeah. Okay. Anything else? Predefined images? Yes. Wonderful. So that UI is user friendly. Absolutely. So these are the main things that make us use Canva most frequently. So next we are going to cover about why Canva. So one person already answered that it is easy to use. So everything that is that you want to change in any of the templates, in any of the design elements, it's all available on the screen. Unlike any other tools, you don't have to go for different menu bars or any other toolbars to select other options. It's right there and it's very user friendly. And the second thing is there are multiple options. So there is a lot of pre-built content here. There are thousands of templates that you can just choose, edit, and you're finished with your design. And even you have different design elements. So for a line or for a dot or something, you don't have to Google and import it again. Everything is already available on Canva. Similarly, even there is a photographs library as well. So any photography that is relevant to you, again, according to brand guidelines, you can just use it in your designs, which are already available. Now, the third thing is the portability. Actually, this is the best feature in Canva. Most of the designing tools do not provide that. That is portability. So, you know, there are many times we create meticulously a design sitting on our PC, but a person is just calling us and bugging us to send a design to them. And so you don't have to worry about that, because you can just install Canva in your phone or any device that you already have. You can send it across. So all you have to need is just an account, a free account. That is all it needs. And the fourth point is collaborative. So this is one thing I love the most, because if you want more than one person to make changes or to design, to edit the same design, this is the best option that you can find in Canva. Now, in portability, because of collaborative nature, you know, sometimes the Toastmaster of the day is making a poster, but the brand, it's not exactly brand compliant. So they can just send the edit link to the VPPR. They can make it all brand compliant and send it across. So that is about collaborative. And last but not least, you can create your own personal repository. So you don't have to have storage. You don't have to download it and create a folder in your PC. Once you're creating a template, it is right there in your account, sitting in your account. Not only with the template, but also with regard to the photographs. So once you're uploading the photos, it's right there. So you have made an appreciation poster about a person. Next time you want to use the same photo, you don't have to upload over and over again. It's going to be there in your repository. So to summarize, it is easy to use. You have multiple options, a lot of pre-built content. It is very portable, it's collaborative, and you can have your own personal repository. So this is why most of the people are very fond of Canva, especially in the context of Toastmasters. Now, talking about thing most of the Toastmasters are fond of, there is one other thing we Toastmasters love. That is specific purpose. You know, we all Toastmasters want to identify specific purpose everywhere, don't we? So that is similarly, even in when you're making a design, first you have to do is identify the purpose, as in why exactly you're making any design. So there are multiple reasons why you have to make a design. It could be a poster, or there are other scenarios. So again, in poster, whether you are sending it across a mail, or you're trying to post it on your Instagram, LinkedIn, or Facebook handle, or it could be any other purposes, like you're making certificates, presentation, newsletter, brochure, or announcements. There are multiple purposes when you have to design something. So first thing you have to do is identify that. So the next step, so now that you have a layout in your mind, okay, I have to make a poster now. So what to do next? So we are going to first navigate through that. Can someone disable the annotations? There's some line over here. Host, can you please help me with that?
Yes, for sure. I'm checking the option. Just you carry on with that.
Yeah, thank you. All right. So firstly, when you're going with Canva, the first screen that you look at is this one. So you can either create an account with Google, Facebook, Apple, or you can sign up with any other things. So let me just go with a brand new account, which I've created. Yeah, so this is how you're gonna get the home page. So the reason why I said you need to identify the purpose is, firstly, you have to select any layout that you're going to create a design in. So let me just go with a flyer. I'll take a flyer. So now we'll explore the options that are available in Canva, how to change the text, color, everything. So we are going to explore that. Let's go for a pre-built template. Let's go with this one. And also the second thing you need to do when you're before you start off the design is keep your resources intact, as in keep all your logos, everything downloaded in your PC to upload it. And also you can have it, you can have all the details about any design that you're making. For example, I'm making a flyer regarding PowerPoint presentation. So I want everything intact, all the content, so I can just directly drop it in my design. So first thing, let me remove this one. I wanna change. Sorry for that. So let me first go with the main thing, training on PowerPoint presentation. So as you can see, generally what happens in the pre-built templates is most of the elements are grouped. So make sure, so you can see here, these are like two different elements. So just select it, select that, and make sure you're ungrouping them so you can modify them individually, as you can see here. I want to just go with this one. So yeah, first you select here and you can change the font here. Let me go with Montserrat because that is free, semi bold. Yeah, and similarly I can change the text here by Cyril Thomas. Okay, that's the only thing I can come, that's the only thing that came in my mind, Cyril. So yeah, and I can make it italic, bold. You can even change the colors over here. You can change the size over here as well. Now the next thing I want to do is let me just fill in the details and let's quickly navigate through all the options. Let me leave the space for the Toastmasters logo. Now I'll have date. So I can select date. So you can make sure you all have this one. Let's anyways try to change the colors later. We still have division EFGHN PR initiative. So yeah, so now we are done with this. So the next thing I want to do is make it brand compliant. So first thing I want to do is change the colors of it. So I'll have the color palette of Toastmasters, or I actually have this one already here. So yeah, so I want to go with loyal blue. So let me change the colors of this. So after you just select this element and you go and change the color over here. This is one general query most of the people had. So you're going here and selecting the new color and pasting the hex code here. So it automatically changes. So once you're using this color, every time you select anything, your color is automatically displayed here. You can use it again and again. Now the next thing comes to the yellow. All right, so I want to change this to yellow color. So same thing, I already have this one. I want to make it black because that's the main font, main text. So yeah, this one is almost done. Great. So as you can see, this is also grouped. I want to ungroup it and change the color. So for the text as well, let me make it white or let me make it yellow. So I think we're done. So the next option for this, so most of the people are already familiar with all these options. You even have the alignment option as well. If you want to keep it center or you want to keep it right, left, it's completely up to you, but make sure everything is uniform. Now that we are done with the alignment, the next best option for, so I want to change the font for all of these. So I don't want to individually change for each one of them. So this is one of the shortcuts that you can learn, is that select all of them, select the, so every time I'm moving this, I can't do that. So select this yellow one and make sure you lock it here. So am I clear so far about the locking option? Okay, I just had a doubt in the text box. Yes, so black font is allowed, but black background is not allowed. So yeah, that is one thing. So the lock option is for, I want to select all these elements without disturbing this yellow triangle. So I want to lock that and I want to change all of them. So that is when you use a lock option. Similarly, I want to select all of them, but I don't want this blue color box to be disturbed. So I'm going to lock that. So whenever I'm moving them, those are going to be intact. I hope I'm clear. Yeah. Yeah. So how to lock? So let me just zoom it a little. So you can see the option zoom here. So you can again go with here. So I am pressing this, I'm selecting this triangle, yellow triangle, and you can see the option, the lock. You can see over here. Can you see this? Yeah, so you can lock this so you don't have to, you're not disturbing that again. Yeah. Now, similarly with the blue one, let me repeat that. So you're selecting this blue color box and you're locking that. Same with this bookmark logo, and I want to lock that so nothing is disturbed. So I'm just selecting this. If I want, I can move this as wherever I want without disturbing the background one. And yeah, I'll try to make sure these all are aligned. Yeah. So now this is all with how you're locking it. Now the next option is I want to change the font of all of this text. So I'm selecting all the text. I'm making sure they are semi-bold. Yeah. I want these as well in semi-bold. Yeah, so I think we are done. If you want, you can make sure they all are of the same size. Let me keep it as 10. That would be ideal. Or yeah, let me go with 12. So yeah, again, it's going to be all about trial and error. So as you edit, you are going to see whatever is more apt for you based on your choice. And then I want to move it a little. I want to reduce the size. So you can either select both of them together, or because you want to make sure they are sticking together, you can group them. So yeah, I'm done with this thing, and this also looks fine, but the font is different. So let me make it semi-bold to make sure it's properly aligned. So you can see this pink lines, which is suggesting you to make sure it is in the center. So you can see the suggestions and make sure it is properly aligned. Now the next thing, it's still looking a little empty. I want to first, let me go with an image that is brand compliant. So as you can see, the templates are all over here. You can see the upload option. So here you can upload any images that are already in PC. So once you see this, you can see upload an image, and you go for device, then you can go for any of the images like this. I hope I'm clear. So I want to go for desktop and say TM. I want to select this logo. It's simple as that. So you can use it later. But right now I want to use some simple logo that can go in that blue color strip. So yeah, that's how you upload the pictures, and you can always resize it. Now that we are done with it, I want to add an image, because this training is going to be like a webinar. Let me try to see if there are any pictures related to webinar. So yeah, this looks fine, I guess. So I'll make sure it is properly placed. If I want again, similar to one. Yeah, now if you observe, once I'm inserting the image, it is overlapping all the elements in the background. So what you do, you select this image, click this option called position, and position you can see to backward, it's going to go one element at a time. So you can see it's slowly going backward. So I hope I'm clear. If not, please feel free to ask me. I'm taking that as a yes.
Just so one question, Sparsha.
Yes.
So when you're inserting the logo, so when you're resizing the logo, you need to press anything like shift or something so that the resize is one is one?
Not necessary. So as you can see, let me just do that again. So once I'm selecting this option, I'm not using anything. I'm just resizing this one. You don't have to use any other tool, any other key for that. That's not necessary. If you want to change the width or length separately, then you can use these options, but I don't want that. So I'm just doing that for a proportional resizing of any picture or any logo. So I think that's pretty much it. You're making a considerably neat poster using the tools that are available in Canva. So you have learned, I suppose, you all have understood how to use the lock option and ungroup and group option, the positioning option. And if you want, so most often what I do is when I'm sending this poster to someone and I want them to make any changes, I try to duplicate this. So how you're duplicating this? You can see this option called duplicate page. You can go for it. So I'm keeping this intact. I ask them not to touch. So they're only doing anything to this poster. So that is how you can duplicate the poster as well. If you want, you can delete it. It's completely up to you. So this is all about what are the different options available in it. You even have different options like, let me show, elements. So here, if you see the elements option, you can just go here and press line. So you see different kinds of line which you can use for free. There are other elements which are in pro, but we don't find that much necessity when we are making any kind of design. So that is all with lines. If you want, you can have a square, circle, anything. It's totally up to you. Okay, how to share Canva design with VBPR for them to edit? Okay, that's a good question. So what we generally do after your poster is done, the next thing you have to do is either downloading it or you're trying to share the edit link. So here you can see this option called download. So here in download as well, you have many other options. So generally it suggests you to go for PDF print. Make sure you are trying to change that because it's by default PDF. Try to change it to PNG format. So you're going for PNG or JPG, but JPG is still not preferable. Go for PNG and then you need, because there are two pages, I want only the first one. So select page one. That is when you can download it. So that is how you can see that it's downloading. You can share it then in the PNG format. Let me just share it on the desktop. And the next thing, I want to identify it with a name, say PowerPoint poster, meeting poster. Okay, so now that I'm done, I want to share it with someone like Cyril asked. You can go for this option called share. And it's very simple, just say copy link and you can see the options. You can get the link like this. So once someone presses it, you're going to see the exact same design. So that is all with how to send the edit link. However, there is one disadvantage for this. When someone is editing it already, they can't edit it parallelly. So it's basically concurrent editing is not possible. So make sure that when you're editing with the edit link, make sure the other person is not doing anything to that. So that is one thing you need to remember when you're giving the edit link for someone. And besides that, you have many other options for PDF print. You can even have it in the form of a GIF or an MP4 video. So the video and everything, Furkan is going to take care. I'm not suggesting anything about it. We can probably take it in the next session or offline. So PDF print, this is generally for, as it suggests, for printing. The standard one is when you are trying to share it across in groups or anything, in email or something. So you have all these options when you're trying to share your designs. That is all with how to make the posters with the pre-existing template and how to make it brand compliant. I hope I'm clear so far. If anyone has any doubts, you can dig in, just relevant to this particular poster.
I have a question. Let's say that in my club, there is a student who would like to be the Toastmaster of the day, and I would like to add his picture with a circle crop on it. How do you do that?
Okay, so what we do generally, that is why we have these elements over here. As you can see, I was about to cover this in the Fix and Shine part. If you let's try to take that in the last part of the session. Is that fine? Okay, I'm taking it as a yes. So all these kind of things, I'm anyways trying to share it in the last segment. I hope you guys can wait till that. So this is all with the options. Now let's go for a poster. I'm trying to make it from the scratch. So I'll again try to go for a flyer. I'll rather take a blank one and say it's some meeting poster. So I want this one. I think I've uploaded some pictures. Okay, just give me one moment. I have it in another folder. So what actually happened is instead of using, so last year when I was a VPPR, I made my own PR initiative where instead of having the TI pictures, we thought of having a photo shoot and, you know, taking some pictures like this. So we generally use these kind of pictures whenever we are holding any, when we are making any design. So again, it's a fun activity. If you want in the offline session, you can absolutely do that. It's going to be very fun, trust me. So yeah, this is with the about the photo that I'm using right now. Yeah, so this photo is uploaded. Yeah, perfect. So let me try to reposition this. Yeah. Trying to reposition this. So yeah, again, if I want to change this, change the position of it, I can double click on this and you can move it like this, right? So I want to keep it like this at least one. Sorry, Rupali, I'm cropping you out because of the layout. All right, so this is the picture I want to use for this poster right now. Let me lock this because I don't want to interrupt it ever again when I'm making this poster. So I'll just try to have an element on over it. So you can see it's already there. The shape is already here. I'm placing it exactly to this layout. So this is one of the cool options here. I'm trying to use the transparency tool here. So again, sorry, because I'm using the basic account, it's kind of here and there, but once you get used to it, I hope it's not that confusing. So I'm pasting the hex code. Again, it is overlapping. So what I'm doing here, select this rectangle and I'm reducing the transparency so it looks a little Toastmaster-ish. So I'm using this color to that as well as I want to even add the text on it using all the meeting details. So let me add some text, say moments of truth. Okay. Let me make it Montserrat same way. Yeah, so this is properly aligned. Now, because the details of the pictures are still visible, let me move that. Let me zoom it a little and move it on top. Yeah, so it's not overlapping with the text that I'm inserting. Again, let me lock that. Lock this as well, or yeah, perfect. So now that it's done, so this is the main theme of the meeting. It could be any theme if you want, you can add that. And I want to say division EFGH NPR initiative. So I'm adding one division EFGH NPR initiative into the account. So division PR, it's up to you whether you want to implement it or not. So let me go with another font, Source Sans Pro. Yeah. Now this looks fine. I want to add this and put it on top. Perfect. Yeah. So I want to add another strip in the bottom and try to include all the details about the club or anything that I want. So if you want, you can choose the same element and you can make a copy of it. So I have the same font and same size. So I say email division PR EFGHN at gmail.com. I'm not sure if that's the correct one, but yeah, I'm just using it. And similarly, I want to make for a task Instagram handle, say division.efghn.pr. Yeah, so this is also properly aligned, I believe. Yep, so let me lock this and yeah, perfect, looks good. Now I want to add the meeting details like meeting ID, say 14. division PR. So I want to reduce the size of it and I want to align it properly. So I'm using the left alignment here. If I want, I can push it this way. I can say contact, say Anuj again. Toastmaster Anuj. Okay, I still don't know whether it's the correct one. I'm just typing the random one. Okay, I don't know. Okay, so again, it's not that visible for me. If I want, I can zoom it using this option. And I want to make it right alignment. I'm going to keep it like this. Make sure again it's properly aligned. Again, the one thing that is left here is Toastmasters logo. So let me make let me leave some space for the logo. Toastmasters logo. I think this looks pretty good. No, this is not visible. Can go for it with this one. This looks pretty decent, I believe. I think that's the only logo that is appropriate for this. So, yeah. So this is the simple poster that I just made. It's totally up to you if you want to jazz it up a little. So finally, it looks this way with a little Toastmaster feel because I added all that. So this is all, I think you all are aware of how to make a poster from the scratch as well. Am I clear so far, guys, or any doubts? Yeah, cool. Is there also an option for adding the FB logo and Instagram logo for mentioning the social media details? All right, so you can do that. Again, you find it in elements. Again, depends on the way you search. So you type Facebook over here, you see many options, but again, since it's not brand compliant, you may choose not to go for it. If you want, again, you're selecting this, you can change the colors for this as well. So you can make it a Toastmaster blue, right? So you can add it that way. Instagram, similarly for Instagram. You can go and you can change the colors for it. It's totally up to you whether you want to change the colors or not, right? The next thing is, because when you are taking the photo of a crowd, is there any way to compress the photo and get it in the pic frame? Sonal, I didn't understand what you said. Okay, would the poster be uploaded on all the media on its own or would we have to do it separately? Yeah, I'm afraid we have to do it separately. Toastmaster Manoj, you have to download it and you have to do that. However, if it's in the mobile, you can do it because as soon as you download, you get the option, you get the suggestions where you want to upload, so you can do that. Now, is there any way to use gradient in Canvas? Yes. Can we change the size resolution of me, for example? So I did not understand the resolution part. I don't think that is available, Cyril, because I've never come across this term resolution. The design is print. Yeah, you can print that. As you can see this print option, this one, and also by default, whenever you're going for the PDF print, it is going for a high quality one. So I think it's going to be a high quality one as much as I used. And can we resize image in phone for the free version? Okay, so yes, we can actually resize the photo in such a way that you go for elements here. you can see this term called frames, or you can just go for a grid option. And first you can select the size. First you can just select the size, if it's an A4, or if you want a square one, you can go with that. And after that, once you upload the photo, you can directly go for it. So you don't have to, in fact, you can delete it. You can use it, use the same frame again. So once you do that, all you have to do is drag and drop in it. So it's according to the same dimensions that you have mentioned before. So yes, you can resize it in that way. And another tip for you all, if you are looking for any other size as the frames, so you can select this. There is an option called frames over here. Once you are going for it, again, in the same way, you are uploading it and just drag and drop. So it's exactly in the circular frame, right? So that is one option. And coming to the limitations of the free version and the pro version, let's get into that in the Q&A session. I'll answer that. We are still left with the tricks and shines part. So I just give in another 10 minutes, we'll be done with the session. So the next part is the tricks that I personally follow when I'm using Canva. That is the, let me just scroll it down. Yeah. So the first thing is, most of the BPPRs that I observe, most of the designs, they have all the brand guidelines followed. They have all the text and everything is perfect, but it looks a little clumsy, or it looks very empty. The main reason for that is the alignment that we are going to talk about, the alignment part. So you can see this is not properly aligned, and there's a lot of white space, which is not necessary. But if you're properly aligning it, it looks much more polished and looks little neat. So you make sure that if this is all, for example, this is coming with the left alignment, make sure you push everything towards the left. Similarly for the center and for the right alignment, and make sure you're not leaving a lot of white space when you're making the design. And the next thing is about the how you're creatively compiling the information. So most often there is a lot of information, you know, especially when you're making an agenda, or you're talking about a person, you're making a convener poster and the you know, a paragraph about them, but you have to stick to just one design and you have to insert a lot of information. Make sure you're trying to use different design elements to make it a little colorful and make it a little creative. So the same design, you see there is a lot of content, I'm making it in this way. So it's the same one, but people can understand and will be able to distinguish between different things properly. So I hope I'm clear. And the next thing is about the gradient. So gradient, you can use it very wisely whenever you are making any poster. It's actually giving you a lot of Toastmasters look. So it looks a little monotonous. It looks a little dull, but if you're giving it a gradient touch, it looks a little different. So that is how you can make use of gradient. So I'm going to share the hex code of the gradient now. So generally the hex code of the gradient is, let me just share with this. One second. So as you can see, the background for this slide, I used the color. This is the actual Toastmaster blue. That is the loyal blue. This is the hex code. But for the other blue, which is actually an authorized blue by TI, this is the blue. I'll be sharing that hex code with you all. So for gradient is not allowed for any other colors, for burgundy and everything, it's not allowed. For only blue, you can use only this specific color whenever you're using the gradient. So that is one thing about it. So make sure you're using it wisely whenever using the gradient, adding the gradient colors in your posters or any designs. The next thing is the transparency. So this is again a very, very common mistake most of the people do. Whenever you're using the transparency, make sure you're using it appropriately. So for example, the poster, in this poster, everything is brand compliant, but it doesn't look so, because these colors, you have reduced the transparency and it doesn't look like a burgundy. It doesn't look like the blue anymore. So make sure you're using it, using the right colors so that the actual colors are visible. So when you can use the colors, probably when you're using the photos and you're trying to have another layer of it to make, to give it a Toastmasters look, only then you can use the transparency, but do not use it so the actual colors are not identified. So that is all about transparency. Now, there are other options that you can use that are very handy when you are making the posters. So if you can see here, I want this text, this one, and all these dots to be repeated in all the slides. So what I generally do, I try to group all of them. So I just replicate and modify it everywhere in the remaining templates. So that is one hand, that thing is very handy when you're making too many designs with the similar properties of the text or any other elements. So that is about the grouping the texts and any other elements. Now the next thing is how you are searching for the good templates. So most of all, what happens is, I know we all are, most of us are not professional designers, so we might not get creative designs, occasionally. So what we generally do is we can either use the templates, or you can actually go for the design inspiration wherever you find. For example, I want to make an EC poster, but when I'm searching it in Canva, I can't search for an executive committee poster. So I say collage. So I can go for a collage where there are multiple photos. So for example, I see this one or I look at this one. So it's a little similar. So it's having like 6 photos. I can use 7, 8. You can use it like that. And you can utilize these kind of templates. So based on the purpose, you can do the search. I want to make an appreciation poster, but I'm not finding a poster which is appropriate for a single person's photo. So I can go for a magazine template. So in the magazine template as well, I can see many layouts where a single person is there. So I can just have it that way and get inspiration from different designs. I can use the same templates and make an appreciation poster, or a keynote speaker poster, or an education session speaker poster. You can make any of such based on the scenario. And if you still did not find any good posters, you can always go to Google and search, let me go for magazine editorial team. I'm sorry, I'm mostly suggesting magazine editorial team because I was working for a magazine, so yeah. So I really like, I want to go for any magazine poster, which is, I want to go for this one. So here, as you can see, you can write the names, you can write the executive committee, like whatever the position is, and you can give a small write-up. You can get small write-up from each person. And as you can see, there is another template here. You can absolutely go for this template as well. So this is how you're going to get design inspiration, looking at similar designs, and you can add a lot of your style and a lot of your flavor to the poster. And the next thing is the background remover. So you can see I want this picture, but I want the background to be removed. So as you can see, even in this one, the background is not there. It's only that person's photo. So in that case, I can anytime just go here, background remover, and so there's this one website, you can upload the image and you can always get the transparent background image with that, and you can again use it in the Canva. And the next thing is the photo fitting option, the same one that I was talking earlier. So if you want to fit a photo in a circular frame, what you generally do, go for elements and press the keyword frame. So when you're pressing the keyword frame, you can see different of them. So you can see the square one, triangle, you you have several of those frames, so you can absolutely fit in them. If you want, you can go for hexagon. I am just going for hexagon frame. I get this one as well, somewhere here. So you can see this is a hexagon frame. I can get this as well. And another one is another question about gradient. You can have a you can just press gradient. So yeah, so you can press this gradient and you can see there's a square like this. So you can just change the colors according to that hex code that I was talking about before. So you're already getting this kind of gradient, right? So this is how you utilize the gradient option using the frames and other options available in the elements of Canva. And the next thing is the view option for deck. So now generally what happens in any of the conferences or any of the presentation in milestone meetings and stuff, there are so many slides and you have many timer cards, you have many, we'll have a Q&A session right after the session, right after this after the segment. Just please hold till that time. So as I was speaking, in many of the presentations, there are so many slides. As you can see, there are 67 slides and I want to see if everything is in the order or I want to duplicate some slides. So what you can do is go for a grid view. So you can press this on the number of slides and then you can see the grid view of this. And trust me, this is very handy, especially when you're dealing with large presentations. So here, what you generally do, I want to replicate all these three slides and I want to insert it again and again. So you can see this as duplicate and I am trying to insert it over here. So as you can see, it's already there. So this is how you can see if everything is in order. If you want, you can duplicate it. And this is how you can utilize the grid view option here when you're dealing with the large presentation. And the last thing in the session I want to cover is the color palette. So generally what happens in the pro account, you can have your own color palette, but you do not have that option in the free account. So what I'm doing, I'm already having this, all the colors, I put it like this. So every time I'm adding a design, for example, I'm adding this design. So it's going to be right there. And every time I'm choosing it, by default, it is going to be here. So I don't have to paste the hex codes again and again. So I just have to change the colors. I am just doing this. It's all right there. So this is how you are going to utilize this. And this is all about making your own color palette. So again, so you're done with this color palette and I want to utilize the same color palette again and again for the next template. Then I just go to all your designs and I search for color palette. So this template is already there. So if you want, you can edit this or you can make a copy as well. So there is another beautiful option, a very handy option, that is making a copy of your templates. So all you have to do is just go to your designs and make a copy of this particular design and you can use it anytime you want for any other purposes. So yeah, I'm done with this. So every time I can use the same colors anytime that I want. So I think these are the tricks and shines that I've identified that I've been discovering and using for more than one and a half years. So of course, the more acquainted you are with this platform, the more tricks you will be finding on your own. And when you discover, please try to share it with me. I'm super excited to explore them. So I think that is all from my end, guys. So I'm so delighted that I was able to complete this on time, first of all, because there were a lot many things to cover. So I hope I'm done. I will share the gradient hex code during the Q&A session. And I really want to thank you all for being very patient to see this and to see all the to know all the tricks and shines. And besides all this, I want to conclude on one note that whenever you're making a design, make sure that you are proofreading all the content first. So if a Toastmaster of the day is giving you a content first, try to proofread that before you putting in the design. And the second thing, always give a choice for anyone who is asking you for the design. So both the parties are being satisfactory. So make sure you do that. And last but not least, always stick to the brand guidelines. Give Toastmasters its own identity. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much. And with this, I hand over to the MC, Toastmaster Rupali.
Thank you so much, Sparsha, for that insightful session. I'm pretty sure that the tips and tricks will help everyone here. And honestly speaking, even I learned a couple of tips and tricks. So thanks a lot. Now with this, we come to the Q&A session for this segment. And the platform is now open for attendees to clarify if they have any doubts. Everyone can go ahead, raise their hand, unmute and ask their doubts.
We already have few questions in the chat. Sparsha, can you check them and answer them?
So one question, one interesting question is, what are the limitations in the free version? So Toastmaster Manoj, actually in the free version, you do not get to upload your own fonts. So as you can see, Gotham and Myriad Pro are the two fonts which are not available based on the brand guidelines. So if you are having a pro version, you can upload any kind of fonts that you want. So you can upload Gotham, Myriad Pro, anything else. And another thing is, actually I have, mine is a pro account. So let me just show you what are the different things that you can do in a pro version. Just give me one moment. So as you can see, I created my own palette here. So every time, though I have a separate design template for the colors or not, any kind of design that I make, it's by default coming up with these kind of colors. So that is one best option in the pro account. Another thing is uploaded fonts. So I uploaded all this TI brand compliant fonts, which are already not available in the free version. That is one another advantage. Another thing is there are many elements which are not available in the free version. For example, I'm going for public speaking. I can see that there are only few. So as you can see, this is a pro version. So there are many other elements which are really cool, but they're not available in free version. So if you upgrade, you can have access to all of them. So that is the difference between, I hope I cleared your doubt, Toastmaster Manoj. Right. Do we have newsletter template in Canva in terms of size for Canva? Yes, we do have a newsletter template as well. You can go and check because we are already running out of time. So yeah, you can just go and check with that. What if I have like the poster sample and there is a logo or a watermark? Would remove background, remove the logo or watermark? Okay, so generally, I will just told when there is a pro element, so an element that is only accessible for the pro account, you generally observe the watermark. So either you have to upgrade it or you have to use an alternative for that. So I think that I've answered most of the questions. Anything else? Rupali, you can take it ahead.
Yes.
Excuse me, if you could just actually answer my question again. You know, I didn't understand the watermark part that you were talking about.
Right. So generally, you observe the Canva watermark when you're accessing an element from the pro account. So for example, there is an element which is not available for the free version. You can see the work, you can see the watermark Canva. So you can't remove that in a free account. You have to upgrade it, then you can remove that and download it. Otherwise, you have to go for an alternative. You have to download it from the Google, or you can see alternative elements in the Canva itself. So I hope I'm clear now. Yeah, I think.
Okay. Yes. So I'm assuming there are no more questions. So with this, so this was all about Canva and its most effective ways in terms of Toastmasters. Now, PR is a very is very creative, especially when it comes to giving life to your ideas. But nowadays, videos have become a very powerful tool across social media platforms, especially Facebook. But recently in August, Toastmasters released their new brand manual, and it had a section called Video Guidelines. And I remember the moment I saw it, I read those 5 or 6 points and I was scratching my head the entire time. I was a little confused when I first read them. So to help us with that confusion and give us an idea about what is the right content for every platform, we have our next session. So to conduct this session, we have Toastmaster Farkhan, who's a part of current division PR team, has been a Toastmaster for around 7 months now. He is a runner-up from MOC 2018, a speed-coming athlete. And with this, let us welcome Toastmaster Farkhan.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rupali, for this session. So a quick disclaimer for everyone. My Wi-Fi just got disconnected at the nick of the time, so I would try my best to present it from my mobile phone through mobile data. So let me check if my screen is visible with you all or not. Just hold on. Can you see my screen?
Yes, it is visible.
All right. So, hello everyone. My name is Mohammad Farkhan, and it is my honor, it is my pleasure to thank you members, the PR team, and everyone behind Toastmasters to allow me to be part of this session. Is my video on? Can you see my hand waving?
No, we can't see your video.
Yeah.
You can't see my video. Okay. What do I do? The PPT, can you see the PPT?
Yes, the PPT is visible.
Okay, the PPT is visible. So I think I'll manage this way. Forgive me for the video. So video content for social media. Why do we need video content? Here's the thing. I must tell you that I have been into video content for a very long time, but haven't got any much reachability by it. But few videos have worked out for me. So in this session, why I would like to share about video content is because we have Toastmaster channels all across social media. It could be Facebook, it could be Instagram, it could be LinkedIn, or maybe perhaps if you are from China, it could be also on TikTok. I'm not sure, but let's move on ahead with this session. What will your takeaways be like today? First, it's gonna be video content. Why do we go for video content? Second, why do we brand these videos? Third, what aspect ratios for each platform would you recommend or would you go for when posting them on social media? How do you edit them? How do you edit your videos for specific clubs or divisions or district pages or anywhere on social media? So let's start off. Why video content? Let us all go back to July 2019. At this point, I was the past runner-up for Master Orator Championship Season 3. Season 4 was coming up. I was happy that I got invited to be the part of the PR team. The location lead role was given to me. And at this point, my aim was to reach out to everyone in Karnal. My aim was to reach out to everyone in Karnal so that they get to participate in Master Orator Championship. Now, social media, you know, it's the greatest tool by far. Social media is the greatest tool by far. It is the thing that brings reachability across anywhere. Across anywhere. You couldn't even imagine how strong that this tool can get. So what happened? July 2019, I thought I could go for a blog post talking about my personal experiences despite winning Master Orator Championship. What stories, what anecdotes, what narratives, and what perks would you get by just contesting an MOC qualifying round? So this blog post, I had published it on my WordPress site. Now I put the website link in my bio, and what was required was I got to announce about it. So Instagram, I got to announce about it, either it's through post or through stories. What do we do now? So if you were in my place, you would have either gone for a couple of pictures and talking about some short experiences, giving them a little bit of taste of your blog, or you would have gone for a screenshot of your blog post. A screenshot would also would have worked, or maybe the most fearful thing we all would do would look for caption ideas to announce what you want to announce on social media. Don't you think we all relate to this? So video content. I thought I could do something with a video. I just took out my smartphone. I started recording a 51-second video talking about, hey, there's this blog post on my Instagram bio. You can go for it and click the link, explore. And also I tagged Master Orator Championship with the page. And what happened? When I was publishing this video, which were divided into four different streaks, 15 seconds per video. So four different streaks, I started uploading. And when they were finished uploading, two thoughts came into my mind. One, what would people around would consider? What would people would think of my eyebrows and my on my hairstyle? Because I just got out of the bed to finish publishing my blog post. Second, what would the people behind MOC channel would think? Because it feels like ye to zyada hi kar raha hai. But there are some anxious feelings that happen when you record a video, even before you click the record button on your camera. But still, when I went for it, half an hour later, when I came back to my smartphone, there were about 34 shares, 16 replies to me, and so many people started to follow me. But it's not that you're looking for followers, but it's that how far have you reached with only one piece of content, which was a means of communication, video content. Videos are strong enough to connect with people. Videos are strong enough to connect with people. I tell you again, it makes a sweet difference. You write a text, people read it. They have their eyes on it. You sing a song, people have their ears on it. But you record a video of yourself and start speaking and maybe add a little few elements or call to actions. They have their eyes, ears, and their whole attention on what you're talking about. They are looking at the face, they are listening to you, and they get to see that they are engaged into the talk. That's why video content matters most on social media. It increases your reach. Everything clear from here? I just cannot see the questions in the chat box because I am live from mobile. So it's best that you open up your microphone and ask questions to me. Everything cool if the co-host would give an announcement?
Yes, Toastmaster Falcon.
Okay, thank you. So next, why video branding? Now you got your videos, you got your specific details to be shared on social media, you got your material, but branding is necessary. As an organization, as a member of an organization, as a member of your club, as a member of Toastmasters International, branding is really necessary, despite whatever technicalities and whatever creative aspects you got for your video editing mastery, branding guidelines still apply to whatever videos you get to edit. So here are some challenges that you would be likely having at this moment, and I'm sure it's because of these challenges you're here in this talk. One, you are good with posters, but not with videos. Second, your social channel doesn't seem to grow. It does seem to grow. You may have channels, connections, and thousands of shout outs go along, but you don't grow that much as you go for expectations. Next, you aren't familiar with just the video branding guidelines. You're good with videos, but you aren't sure how to make an identification that it's from the Toastmasters and not from you alone. Your club president expects you to be creative. Is your president trying to be bossy enough to tell you to go for something beautiful, go for something? You get it. You are fine with videos, but you want to avoid many heart attacks. You don't know what the branding guidelines are, but you're not sure what would happen if there are some mini heart attacks from the PR manager or someone from Toastmasters who would message you and tell you, you know, this was wrong. You shouldn't have added this logo, or you shouldn't have placed it in this way or that way. It would have been difficult for you. I'm sure you are in the right place. You're going to take a lot of takeaways. It's going to be smooth and easy. let's start off with what the branding guidelines offer us. Number one, add the disclaimer. The disclaimer looks something like this that you got to add in the first few frames of the video. Toastmasters International and all other Toastmasters, trademarks, so-and-so, video, corporate, associated, everything. Second, you go for the logo. You add a logo of whatever color you prefer that is available on the Toastmasters site and use that logo and place club name or district name right below the logo. I'll tell you what font you're gonna use. Next, you got to add the credits at the end of the video. Who is going to make the video? Is it you alone? Is it Rupali? Is it Sparsha? Is it Cyril? Is it you, the whole team, PR team or division EFGHN? Who are you? What are you going to do? So to keep it easy for you for how you can add the credits, line one, name of the team of the name with club and with district. And in the second line, you got to add the district or the club name with a copyright symbol and a year. Well, I use this for my photographs on Instagram, so it seems easy for me to do, but I will make it easy for you as well. So here are some examples. This is how a traditional disclaimer would look like if you add on your video in the first few frames, Toastmasters and all other Toastmasters trademarks and copyrights are sold. You see this in movies also, right? Like in movies or like short films on YouTube. Like they don't want to get caught for infringing copyright, or they don't want to see anyone else using your material for commercial and non-commercial use. Second is the logo and the club name / district number that you got to add on your video. Third is the credits, the EC team or the name Muhammad Furkan, RG Titans, District 98. And the second line goes with copyright symbol, the district number and the year in which you produce your video. So what aspect ratios do you go for this platform? Before I begin, let me check if there are people who would like to have questions or anything. Anyone? Okay, I think I'll take that as a yes. Rupali, give me a confirmation.
Yes, Farkan, we can go ahead.
All right, sure. So aspect ratios, why are aspect ratios really important? I must confess, aspect ratios do make a lot of difference. They do make a lot of difference, I must confess. Why? Because no matter how the video recording would be, after the editing process, when you post them on social media or Instagram, anywhere, taking up the whole or almost most of the part of the screen is enough to attract the audience's attention. The person who is watching on screen. Yes, you may go for 16:9 version. You may go for 1:1 version. You may go for 4:5 version. You may go for the portrait version that we have in the fourth image. But it's really important that you decide what aspect ratio you choose for the right for the specific social media handles. Now 16:9, it sounds cool. It can go for IGTV, Instagram. It can go for Reels. It can go for YouTube, which is the most preferred, and it can also go for Facebook, but for more dynamic presence and for more of mobile stable videos, you can go for 1:1, 4:5, or 9:16. The safest one that I would consider is the 4:5 version. It's easy. You can make an IGTV video out of it. You can post it on Facebook. You can post it on Instagram. You can post it even on your WhatsApp statuses also. And you can also, if you prefer to, you can also upload it on YouTube, because anyhow, people get to watch YouTube on mobiles mostly. So let's start off. How to brand and edit your videos. How to brand and edit your videos. It's important. This is the most important part. I'll talk about the softwares that can be used to brand your videos. There are two types of softwares from my knowledge. The paid softwares are Vegas Pro, which is by Sony, and the Premiere Pro, which is by the Adobe. The free apps, they are available on mobile. One is the YouCut and the other is Vita. It's newly launched, but I'll just show you how you can brand and edit your videos on the YouCut app in this mobile. So these are the free apps that you should be considering. Let me just switch over to my mobile application, YouCut. I hope you are able to look at the screen, everyone.
Yes, yes, it's visible.
Awesome. So I just go for any fresh, unedited, natural video. Now, if you'd notice, this video was made for Bits Pilani Hyderabad orientation promo, and it is yet to be edited, but I'm using it for a demo version. Now, you may be familiar with how you can split or cut the videos according to your preferences, taking out the non-necessary material from the video like this. 3, 2, 1, I do not want this, so I just select the video, I click split, I select this one, and I just delete this. So this is my beginning. Smooth, easy peasy. Now, what do I want to do in the beginning? The disclaimer. I got to add the disclaimer. Now, you cannot add a disclaimer over the video. I suggest it's safest that you go for a background color first that comes on the screen. Let me just crop this video to a particular mobile aspect. Done. 4x5. And then I go to photos. I go to a place where I downloaded the background images for use. And there you go. I just have a background image. This can go for whatever duration you prefer, 4, 5, 6, 7, however you like. I would go for 3.3, let's say. This is how the intro goes. Now, how do you brand the video first? That's more important. You go to stickers and you go to the plus sign, and wherever you download the logos, that is where you will be able to access the logo of Toastmasters. If you're not sure where to download the logos, you can just go for toastmasters.org/logos. Okay, slow internet, forgive me for this. When you visit the web page, make sure that you download the PNG file of your logo, not the JPEG, the PNG file of your logo. Because if you add the JPEG file, you would also get a white background behind this, which would be a little more disturbing and annoying. So it's best that you go for the PNG. It's more dynamic, it's more appealing. Next, I'll just add this to any of the few corners that I have on my smartphone on the screen.
And go over here.
Next, what do we have to do? We get to add this logo throughout the whole video so that it stays strict to the guidelines. Next, we need to add the text. And what's my text goes like? District, hold on. District 98. And if you cannot find the preferred font that you are looking for, just go to this plus option, go to import fonts, and wherever you download your fonts from, from the internet, you would find them over here. Just make sure that your font file is of OTF or just TTF file format. Now for now, I have downloaded the Myriad Pro font. I just click on it and it gets easily installed. I could also go for Monster Pro, the alternate version, or just Myriad. There you go. I take it to where the branding guidelines insist me to, right below the logo. And you're good to go. Just make sure that your even the District 98 text goes up to the video end. So now your video is branded. Now let's add some spice and some editing tools that we can use to spice up this video. One thing's left, the disclaimer. Let's pretend that this is a demo Toastmasters disclaimer quote. All right. I can also choose to go for a light version of the same font. I can place it in the center. And you're good to go. This is your intro. This is where your disclaimer goes. Now your video is branded halfway through the project. Sorry, that's bad. This should go all the way in the beginning. Right. Now that looks a little bit abrupted. And you want to add a little easiness in the visual aspects of the video. You see this icon between the two elements. There's this slant line option. If you select, it takes you to the transitions of what the app provides. You can go for the mix, which goes something like this. Or you can go for the fade black. Or you can go for the fade white. This is my favorite, the fade white one. I like it. I'm gonna go with this one for now and look at it. Let me edit this a little. Huh. So this is how your demo goes. The disclaimer goes, you come up and that's it. That's how you apply the brand to your video. Next, what do we have? So on. Next is adding the credits to your video with the same thing that I did in the beginning. I go to plus again, I go to gallery, I go to wherever the background image is stored. I can prefer whatever duration I need for this. I add a visual effect. Fade white. Now, how do you add the credits of the video? Just hold on. What did I say first? Club name, name of the person who created the video, Mohammed Furkan. RG Titans, District 98. This will be my first line, and the second line that I added was in the PPT. One second. The second line was it doesn't matter what chronology you follow, but what matters is you added the right elements in your text because it's a copyrighted material. I go for District 98 and then the copyright symbol from your keyboard and the year in which you create your video to keep it detailed. And there you go. This is how the copyright and the credits work in the end of the video. So let's take a look once again. I played back. I hope the screen is visible to all. Rupali, can you confirm?
Yes, it is visible.
All right. So this is the disclaimer. We got the logo. We got the club name / district number underneath. Just play the video. Finish. And that's how your credits are done. A little bit a touch up. And I think we still have another 30 minutes. So let me go on for more of the spices that you can add to this video. Two things that I would like to share with you. One is either you add the name of the person who is in the video. Let's say runner-up WCPS 2025. I think I can differentiate both of them. I added somewhere over here. I add another text, runner up WCPS 2025. This is just a demo video. Don't consider me as a runner up of WCPS. Ah, this is difficult. Okay, whatever. I think you can manage this by your own for how proper you want the indentation or the alignment be. And you're good to go. That looks good. But you also want to add effects to the font that appears over here. Can just select any of these fonts. You see another menu coming up when you select one. There's the animation, fade in, fade out. Same for this, fade in, fade out, and done. Easy peasy. Now, if you still want to look for the detail of how smooth this goes, or how fast or how slow does each of these effects go, let me just hold on. There's a timing for each of these effects. I got this very recently. I checked it today at 2 p.m. It's really good. 5 seconds. Done. See, that's how it works. Whoever speaker you have in your video, whoever shares the material, you can get to add their names, their recognition, whatever, their distinguished Toastmaster, whoever they could be. You can just add their names and their recognition right underneath, or just go for District 98. Use Spark with your own creativity. It's all in your hands. Just stick with the branding guidelines that I showed with you. The credits, the disclaimer, and this one. Now, this was one of the two things that I was going to share. The second thing was adding subtitles. Now, this is my dialogue. I want to add subtitles to these first three dialogues that I share in the video. I come from a humble town where, one second. I come from a humble town where I didn't see opportunities. Done. There you go.
I come from a humble town.
Make sure that it touches at the exact point where your dialogue begins.
I come from a humble town where I didn't see opportunities that would help me.
Opportunities
that would.
And you can still continue with this. Select this one. Select copy. And you can drag the copied one over here and you can place it over the next dialogue that you're about to share in the video. Select that again. and you can edit it. Opportunities that would help me. That would help me develop my public speaking skills. Nor until in my, do not hesitate to increase the width of the subtitle. Just hold on. Arre, why did I drag? Okay, never mind. This is how your subtitle goes.
Where I didn't see opportunities that would help me develop my public speaking skills. Not until in my third year in college, where I got to see this whole platform of public speaking called Toastmasters International.
And that's how you can make videos for on and on and on with all those subtitles till you reach the end, however you like. Or you can just go with the name of the speaker in the video with the recognition that they have, and you're good to go. This is your complete project that you can upload on your Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, WhatsApp, TikTok, whatever social channels that you run. You can upload these videos right on the spot. Just one thing to make clear for about Instagram, when you're looking to upload this on Instagram, just make sure that this video doesn't come in a 4x5 format. That's the only thing. That's just a short disclaimer for my end. I'll save this video for now, which is a 4x5 version. And in the meantime, let's just talk about more of video branding. So I forgot to add one thing. So here's the thing regarding the branding guidelines. You got the three elements that I was supposed to share with you. Add the disclaimer, add the logo with the district number below, and add the credits in the video with however you prefer. Two things to remember. One, whoever the speaker is in the video, you will have to submit a video release form where the speaker admits that he is in the video, and it can be used in any of the Toastmaster channels for any of the specific needs whenever they are needed for video content. The video release form is available on the website, which you can find in the branding manual. Okay, this is not clickable. Okay, Toastmasters.org. Some kind of a link would be available over here. If it was my computer, I could have shown it in the nick of time. So these are the two things you got to remember. One, video release form from the one who is in the video material. And second, make sure that this video material does not contain any copyright material. Copyrighted content like music, which is created by someone else, or a video of someone that is outside Toastmasters, a TED talk or something else, or any kind of a logo, any kind of an image that does not fit with the copyright infringement rules. Also make sure that your Toastmaster videos will not be responsible for whatever content that you share. It's all open on the disclaimer. You can read it right here. The video is the opinion of the creator and is independent of Toastmasters International. It is not authorized, not endorsed, not sponsored, not affiliated with or otherwise approved by Toastmasters. It's necessary that you got to learn about this. So my video is made and we are good to go. Take a look.
I come from a humble town where I didn't see opportunities that would help me develop my public speaking skills.
Drag it all the way to the end.
Who knows, even you might thank yourself later down the line.
Done. And that's how you create a 4x5 version of a video. This is the safest aspect that I would consider for any social platform. you know, it's the most mobile is the most used platform. We can always agree for this. Maybe in the coming generations, I don't know what devices would come, but for now, this is what I would prefer most of the time. I do this the same for some of my YouTube videos that I put on my Instagram and also on my WhatsApp statuses. It makes it easy for the person who watches my video, and it makes it easy for the person to get connected with the eyes and ears that he pours into the screen. Now, let's say that you have that video stored and you want to post it specifically for IGTV on your Toastmaster channel on Instagram. I go to new project again, and the video that I saved in the 4x5 format, it's best that you go to BG. You select the TikTok version of this. You go to color and go with white, which I feel is the safest one. Why do I suggest this? Is because when you go with a 4x5 version upload on IGTV, it crops out the rest sides of the video. That we wouldn't want the videos to face any issue, and the logos don't even come in the screen. That would be a very big problem. So 19:6, or if your video is in a 16:9 ratio, that would be perfect. IGTV accepts either that or this, but there's no in between. So this is how an IGTV would look, and finish. That's it. So any questions that you have, anything that you find confusing, I'm free to answer. Just switch on your microphones or anything. I can't look at the, how do I say it, the Zoom screen right now.
If I can just ask Mr. Furqan, thank you so much. And you really inspired me. I was very scared, in fact, to make videos and to create posters, but you guys have really motivated me a lot to do this.
Thank you.
Yeah. You see, so now I have three questions for you. The first question is that, can we have something like a new sticker in the bottom scrolling?
I'm sorry, come again?
You see, my question is that, can we have something like a new sticker? Okay, the new sticker, you know, the one that you have in the bottom that keeps scrolling. Can we have something like that in the video?
That can be done in a paid website, I suppose. Or you're talking about the text that goes scrolling all the way in the bottom.
Yeah.
I think what we can do is, hold on. So bad that I don't have internet connection on my computer.
Yes, and if you can also charge your phone, because it is only 18%. Okay, I'm scared your battery may run out. Okay, this is just for information. I just noticed that. Okay, because your battery is only 17%.
I can manage. There's no hesitation in that. So let's go back to the old draft. Yes. You say you want to scroll your text over on your screen.
Yeah, so if it's at the bottom,
if
and you are speaking something, and then, you know, okay, anything that he's speaking is just running down.
So I think this is what you're looking for, or is it that you want it in a way that happens in a news channel?
That's correct.
Right?
That's correct.
Yeah, that can be done on a paid application, like the ones that are on computer, like Sony Vegas Pro or Adobe Premiere. I wish I could have showed it on the Vegas Pro, which is on my computer, but due to technical issues, I'm not able to log in from the computer. Anytime you can ping me in my Instagram or in my LinkedIn, I can help you out with this sometime in the future. Now, I hope you understand.
Yes, I do. Okay, so then the second question is, can we replace your background wall and the cupboard on the left with something else?
Sure, thank you for the feedback. I would, you're talking about the video, right?
Yeah, the video. I just want to ask you, it's a question, okay? You see, so no. I'm not asking you to do that, okay? But so it's just a question, okay? You know, if I want to replace the cupboard, see, and the background wall with something else, can we do that, okay? You know, with the video software that you talked about.
Right. I think this can be possible. I never touched this part of the editing, but I'm sure that there are now softwares available or online editing tools that let you upload a video and remove a background right in a nick of a time, in a snap. That can be found on some certain sites, or maybe they are paid, but if there is any that has easy access towards that specific editing style, I think I can share you a couple of videos that I can find on YouTube. I hope we can connect later with these. So,
sure. For
thank you so much. The third question.
And my last question is that: is there any ways you can change the tone of your original voice? Okay, you know, if you want more depth to your voice, or you know, if you want to sound like, okay, you're Mr. Bachchan, and you want to make that voice to be more deep and stuff like that, or you want it to be, yeah. So is it possible in this software that you have? Can you do that?
In the mobile applications, that would be a little bit impossible, but you will have to take out the audio file separately from the video, and you will have to use another audio editing tool for that. I personally use Audacity. It's a reliable one. It isn't such more of a design specific or anything like that. It's basic, but there's so much flexibility in it that you can use your own creativity. You would be able to find tools like amplification and voice modulation and pitching, the low or the highs of your pitches. Lots of stuff can be found in that. So I suggest you go for the Audacity. It's a reliable tool. It's free. It's available for PC, Windows, and that's it.
Thank you so much, Furkan.
Any questions?
Yes, Furkan. I have a question. That is, you said that we cannot use any music that is copyrighted, as in music that is, you know, given by another singer, let's say, Honey Singh or somebody. So we cannot use that. But there are other musics as well which don't have any lyrics. They're just very upbeating music or some background musics that people usually use in their videos. Can we use those?
Yeah, unless if those videos are not copyrighted, unless those videos have already shared in the description on the internet that you are free to use these music, you are free to use them for whatever organization or businesses that you have, then you can go for them. And also, from my YouTube experience, there are some music tools that are allowed to use, but they prefer that they are given credits in the description box when you're uploading them on YouTube or in Instagram.
Okay.
It's not that for every non-copyrighted music you do that, but there are some sites that give you royalty-free music that don't even care about credits. Just go for the music. You can upload it. You can go for it.
Okay. I had another question that was, let's say I am making an educational video and I want to add a clip from somebody else's speech. Let's say there are a lot of videos, for example, Aaron Beverly's speech. I want to say that this gesture used by Aaron Beverly will help you. So can I use his clip, or should I be asking his permission? Because that is already uploaded by TI. Am I allowed to use that?
This, I think the video forms might not be necessary in this case, I feel, but it's best that you message him on Instagram and tell him that, you know, I'm going to use this video in my tool, in my software. There's this short clip that I would like to introduce with the audience members in my talk. Are you fine with that? And if he's like, "Arey, you go for it. It's YouTube. It's already uploaded." If he's okay with that, then good for it. But it's always best to consider that you have a video release form with yourself and share it with him. Even if he feels frightened and if he feels scared about it. So that's the main thing.
Okay. Okay, I guess that's it. Does anybody else have any questions?
Can we download royalty-free music clips from online? I think we can. There are a few sites, but I don't remember those. It was like long back, 4-5 months before. But you will find royalty-free music online on Google. There are tons today. 2020 is full of so much content available, copyrighted and non-copyrighted.
Okay, so I believe we don't have any more questions.
So I'll just get back to my presentation once.
Okay.
I just want to ask you a question. I just want to repeat what you said is that if we use a 5x4, so it can be used for all type of formats. Is that what you said?
Right.
Furkan?
Yeah. Like, what are you trying to express? I didn't get you.
You see, so now my question is that if we shoot a video in a 5:4 format, it can be used for all the social medias. Okay. Is that what you had said?
Yes. It's not that it's the restrictive aspect for every social media. It's that I consider the safest and most reliable for people who can watch this video. Facebook and Instagram, let's consider you have a portrait version of your video, the 9:16, the TikTok aspect. When you upload these videos on Facebook and on Instagram, no matter they be IGTV or Reels or a typical Facebook video, even if your video is of a full a portrait format, they still show you in a 4x5 mode. But when you enter the video in full screen mode, it takes you to that more deeper version of what your video is about. So that's the thing. You can still go for the 19:6 version, or sorry, 9:16 version, if you pay attention to some of the channels that upload the whole portrait version of the video without anything added around up or below the borders of the screen, a full complete video. They still add branding guidelines, branded tools all over the video, only in that 4x5 ratio, which is still in the bigger version of the video. I hope you get the point.
Yes, I do. Thank you.
Thank you so much. So with this, I go back to my screen sharing.
Okay.
Forgive me for this level of presentation through mobile phone. I know it's...
You need to take care of your battery. Is only 8% for Khan. I'm just trying to...
Right, sure. So these are the free apps. Now I want to conclude to why we still have to go for videos. You got posters, you got everything. But videos are what, like I presented before, videos are what that go for extended reach. Videos are what that help people connect with the audience. Like, listen to me, the sky is the limit. We have listened to this quote for many times. The sky is always the limit. We have heard about it in schools and colleges and everywhere. But you are the Batman. What are your strengths? What are you gonna do when there is a call from the sky? That is my question. Like, you have your superpower of public speaking. You have the technology in your hand, the gadgets around your waist. What are you gonna do when there is a call from the sky? That is my question to you. Will you be able to make a video for your channel, like a promotion for open memberships for new members? Would you be able to open up about certain aspects, like why do you want to renew Toastmasters? Or would you want to make a video about holding a contest for non-Toastmasters students? What is it that you're looking for? Do you want to make a public relation with other people? I'm sure making a video is what that matters most. Yes, written text, written formats, pictures, and the other types of means of communication in content do matter, really. But videos are what that brings so much enthusiasm. It attracts, it brings connection. It's the only thing that brings people's eyes and ears and attention all over the screen. I know social media is a tool that also makes it toxic, but you being the Batman, you also have the responsibility to what specific purposes you have in sharing videos. Are you gonna bring negativity or positivity? That's all in your hands. But dear public speakers, Toastmasters and guests, I'm happy that this presentation is done. I'm happy that we have had a whole lot of learning from this. Do feel free to connect with me on these social platforms, LinkedIn, Instagram, and YouTube. I would like to help you out in any more video editing sessions or whatever projects that you would require. Feel free to, and that's it. I hope you're gonna have an amazing night today. Take care. Over to Rupali.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Furkan. This was indeed a very informative session. Although videos are still new to us, I'm pretty sure after this session, we will be able to incorporate these ideas into our PR notebooks. With this, we come to the end of this session. I have put up a link for the feedback form in the chat box. Feel free to give feedback. And if you ever want to refer back to this session or ask us questions or maybe recommend your own club members to have a look at it, we'll be posting the video on YouTube and we'll also be mailing you the videos of both the sessions which were taken. With this, it's been a pleasure to be the MC for this event. And looking at all the learnings that have come to us, I would like to thank both the facilitators today for taking their time personally and making this event a pure bliss. As a fellow PR person, I have also learned a lot today. So thank you, everybody. Thank you, Division PR team, for making this session possible. And with this, we come to the end. And I hope we meet again. And good night, everybody. Stay safe.
Thank you so much, everyone, for joining. Thank you, Rupali. Bye.